Ramanujan, the man who knew infinity. Ramanujan is a Sanskrit name that translates to little brother of Rama. Rama, often known as Ram, is a Hindu deity. He is God Vishnu's eighth avatar, and one of the most well-known. He is a supreme being, in Hinduism's Rama-centric traditions. However, today we will not discuss Rama, the deity, or his brother, but rather a genius, who revolutionized the fields of mathematical analysis, number theory, infinite series, and continued fractions. The one who solved mathematical problems, previously thought to be unsolvable. Interestingly, he did this all with very little formal training in pure mathematics. Srinivasa Ramanujan was born on December 22, 1887, in the southern Indian state of Tamil Nadu. His ancestors were Brahmins, a Hindu priestly and scholarly caste. Despite their high caste, his family was impoverished. Ramanujan's parents moved frequently, therefore, he went to a lot of different elementary schools. Ramanujan was the top student in his district when he started high school at the age of 10. Even during his childhood, he spent a lot of time in his school's library, reading mathematical books. He began intensive self-study of mathematics at the age of 12, working through cubic equations, as well as arithmetic and geometric series. These early works helped him to come up with his own formula for solving quartic problems. His memory for mathematical formulas and constants seemed limitless. He astounded students by reciting the values of irrational quantities like pi, Euler's number, and square root of 2 to as many decimal places as they requested. Ramanujan graduated from high school in 1904. He had won the school's mathematics prize and, more importantly, a scholarship to study at the Government Arts College. His obsession with mathematics cost him his scholarship when he failed his non-mathematical tests. After moving to Madras in 1905, he attempted the test once more, but failed again. At the age of 19, Ramanujan decided to devote his entire time to mathematics. The areas of mathematics he was working on were both unique and advanced. He was able to find new theorems, despite having very little formal mathematical knowledge. Some believe that his lack of formal mathematics education was perhaps a blessing in disguise. He independently discovered results that had previously been found by some of history's finest mathematicians, including Carl Friedrich Gauss and Leonhard Euler. By 1910, he understood that he needed to work in order to survive. Ramanujan found work at the Government Revenue Department, where he met Ramaswamy Iyer, a government officer. He had no resume to show to Ramaswamy Iyer. All he had were his notebooks, which contained the findings of his mathematical research. Ramanujan was fortunate in that Ramaswamy Iyer was also a mathematician. Iyer is the founder of the Indian Mathematical Society, so he understood Ramanujan. When Iyer saw Ramanujan's works, he was amazed. Iyer used his contacts to help Ramanujan. However, it wasn't simple, because many people assumed Ramanujan had plagiarized the works of earlier brilliant mathematicians. The genius, on the other hand, persuaded all of his detractors, who ultimately became supporters of him. People close to him urged him to publish his works and enroll at a prestigious British university. Ramanujan and his colleagues attempted to contact a number of British professors, but only one responded. Godfrey Harold Hardy, generally known as G.H. Hardy. Hardy, a prominent pure mathematician at the University of Cambridge, who received a letter from Ramanujan in January 1913. Ramanujan was 25 years old at this point. About 120 theorems on infinite series, improper integrals, continuing fractions, and number theory were contained in the 10-page letter. Professor Hardy was shocked. "This cannot possibly be true. This is not someone's work, but a fake." Hardy, however, discussed the papers with J.E. Littlewood, another prominent Cambridge mathematician, and told Littlewood that they had been written by either a lunatic or a genius, but he couldn't tell which. After spending 2.5 hours delving into Ramanujan's original works, two Cambridge mathematicians reached a conclusion. They were studying the works of a mathematical genius, perhaps the best of all time. Hardy arranged Ramanujan's visit to Cambridge. He came to Cambridge in April 1914, 3 months before World War I broke out, and started working with Hardy and Littlewood. Ramanujan's mathematical brilliance stunned both Hardy and Littlewood. 2 years later, he was given the equivalent of a PhD for his works. Thousands of equations and theorems he discovered between 1903 and 1914 were written down in the notebooks he brought back from India. However, there was an issue with his notes. The habit he had adopted as a child exacerbated the matter. His mathematics frequently offered too few hints for anyone who wasn't a mathematical genius to figure out how he arrived at his conclusions. Ramanujan was the first Indian mathematician to be elected a Fellow of the Royal Society of London. He produced around 4,000 proofs, identities, conjectures, and equations in pure mathematics during his brief lifespan. His theta function remains at the heart of string theory in physics. In his first 3 years at Cambridge, Ramanujan was very happy. His health, on the other hand, had always been an issue for him. The winter temperature in England frequently troubled him. In 1917, he was diagnosed with tuberculosis. His health appeared to have improved enough for him to return to India in February 1919. But Srinivasa Ramanujan died on April 26, 1920, in Madras, at the age of 32. "There was the amazing thing about Ramanujan," says Freeman Dyson, a mathematician and physicist. "He discovered a lot, but he also left a lot for others to discover in his garden." According to the great Hungarian mathematician Paul Erdős, if we grade mathematicians on a scale of 0 to 100 based on sheer talent, Hardy to be rated himself at 25, Littlewood at 30, Hilbert at 80, and Ramanujan at 100. I had never seen anything like them before, said G.H. Hardy, who assisted Ramanujan on his way to Cambridge. Of the letter he received from Ramanujan. Even a single look at them reveals that they could have only been written by a world-class mathematician. They had to be true, since no one would have the creativity to make them up. While on his deathbed in 1920, Ramanujan wrote a letter to G.H. Hardy, outlining various new mathematical functions, along with explanations about how they worked. One of his mysterious deathbed theories has been proven right, almost a century after his death. For nearly 90 years, the puzzle has remained unsolved. However, in 2012, a group of American physicists confirmed that Ramanujan's formula might describe black hole behavior. How could he solve all these mathematical puzzles so quickly and easily, with very little formal mathematical education? Genius said something unique about his works. I had a strange experience while I was sleeping. There was a red screen, made by flowing blood. A hand suddenly started writing on the screen. A number of elliptic integrals were written by that hand. They remained in my head. As soon as I opened my eyes, I put them in writing. The origins of Ramanujan's striking ideas are still a source of debate. However, his contributions to the domains of mathematics and physics are undeniable. Thank you for watching. Please consider subscribing, liking, and sharing, which means a lot to me. I love to see your thoughts in the comment section.